Do it over.
Do it over. Cut it. Cut it.
Hey guys, it's my favorite day. It's Bowie's favorite day.
My favorite day is Saturday.
It's Dennis's favorite day.
It's not David's.
That's not David's favorite day. It's Podcast Monday. How's everyone doing?
Good.
Yes, the three views. Yeah.
Okay. So
this
welcome.
Is a big CJ. You guys know what CJ is? No. Carl's Jr. It's a circle jerk.
So special YouTube edition. Probably the last time we do this.
Depending on our views. I think they're waiting on Twitch. It's like, hey man, when's Podcast Monday?
Whoa.
Hey, Suns Bros.
Hey, it's cool, man. I'm not either. Alright, let's start.
My chat's being weird, sorry.
Oh, how laggy is this?
It's pretty far behind, dude.
Anyways, keep going. Just
it's
keep
like
going.
A minute delay in comparison to Twitch.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
Keep going.
Let's continue.
Sorry, I have so many windows going up, but things not showing. Sorry, let me do this quick, because apparently my chat's not showing up here. I'm sorry, guys. I'm professional, I know. But, John, go over the agenda.
Inner workings. What's going on here?
John, all go right. Over the agenda.
Wow, I'll go over the agenda. Just give me a moment.
What's up, Energist?
So, our agenda today is we're going to first talk about the OCG ban list, effective October. Then we're going to talk about Stretcher Deck R, which is the Monarch Structure deck. Then we're going to talk about the Dimension of Chaos leaks that was shown in about 2 days ago.
The 17th.
Then we're going to talk about the new booster pack changes that will be in effect by Breakers of Shadow. After that, we're going to talk about how we did in regionals. And we're going to talk about the OTS Championship in Core TCG.
And why you shouldn't go.
And then we'll have a very special announcement about the very end.
We usually do Twitch. It's just that we want to test out the waters of YouTube.
Which is probably a bad idea, but... yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
All
so
right.
Let's begin. So, OCG, when we closed out the Podcast Monday last week, literally, before I went to bed, like that Tuesday at 1 in the morning, they showed the new OCG ban list.
This always happens, like, right after we end it, they always show the next, like, news.
Yeah, so...
Maybe you guys should... So, the news comes out on Tuesday, maybe you should do podcasts on Tuesdays.
Or Podcast Wednesday.
podcast
Wednesday.
Yeah,
it's like a midweek thing anyways.
Okay, so, yeah, so, they only banned two cards, but these are two powerful cards. They banned Elder Entity Norden and Telonite Telemiles. Yeah. So both used to be unlimited. Norden's self-explanatory, Telemiles just for the...
Wait. It's not self-explanatory. Please explain it to me. Why did they ban Norden?
It's pretty much using Instant Fusion. It's a free summon. It's a free rank 4 toolbox. There's a lot of loops regarding Norden. They still have Evolved there, right, John?
Yes, yeah. They still have Evolved Chain. At 3, mind you.
All right, good. Now that that's explained.
But Telemiles, it's to neuter the Cyber Dragon Infinity, this name?
Yes.
Because that was the easiest way for every deck to get into it. Now, without an easy way to go to Telemiles, to Nova, to Infinity, you actually had to play maybe legit Cyber Dragon.
Yeah, and I think that this could have been easily mitigated by not making Telemiles generic. Because it's generic, you can pretty much sprinkle into any rank 4 toolbox. Any rank 4 toolbox now has access to Diamond, has access to rank 5s with Ptolemaeus' second effect. So altogether, just a little too many options for just a rank 4.
Very versatile.
That's about it. Any other opinions about it?
I think maybe 3-1 for Ptolemaeus might have been drastic. I think they should have did 3-none. They should have just did limited and see how that went.
Yeah.
If you can get around the first Ptolemaeus, then you kind of ruin their play, right? So, I mean, that should have been enough. But...
mind you, they still have Shockmaster, so Shockmaster and Infinity is GG.
Still a thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, any other thoughts, P-Bunny?
They should have banned...
Oh, they should have banned don't know, OCG land. It's they're crazy over there, man.
I got one. The hell you want. I got one. How about they should have banned Instant Fusion and kept Norden? Whoa.
Well, new other stuff.
I don't know. I think that's useful. Yeah, I guess Instant Fusion. Norden would have no use.
Yeah.
How do you make Norden without Instant Fusion? I don't know.
Polymerization and two Xyz
monsters.
And or a
Synchro.
Do they have
Super Poly? I guess we'd love that, boys. Burning Abyss.
Do they have Super Poly?
No.
Not anymore. They banned it.
Okay, so it'll be useless. No one can make it.
Hey, no. You, Burning Abyss can make it.
BA with the polymerization. It's not a dead draw.
Yeah, man. But, I mean, Norden to BA? Come on.
Sugoys! Or sup, guys?
Sup, guys. Yuki Bro Pros!
Sorry we're doing this. But yeah, let's move on to Limit.
We're very sorry about you two. Biggest regret of our day.
Yes.
So far.
So, Limited list. OCG, they limit Shadow Mist, Glow Ball. Okay, Shadow Mist from 3 to 1, Glow Ball to none to 1, Insight to 3 to 1. DC Diva from 3 to 1 and Shred from 3 to 1.
Start from the top or you want to start anywhere?
Yeah, let's go Shadow Mist first of all.
Okay.
Well, actually, let's talk about Shadow Mist when we get to Bubble Man because that's going to be more important. It links with the Bubble Man, so.
Right. But really quick, I think the biggest thing about Shadow Mist was just the fact that it gave you the search to your change card, your mass changes.
That too, but it's just linked to Bubble Man.
You can go into that later. Yeah. Glow Bulb, awesome.
I mean, we have it at whatever.
We have it at 2 or 3,
yeah,
and then nobody cares.
Nobody cares, yeah.
Synchros is not a thing.
Except for Trish, which they don't have. They do have Trish.
They do have.
They've had it longer than us.
We have Trish. I mean, I don't know. Synchros are just so hard to pull off anyways, and why not make it just a little bit easier? Are they promoting a Synchro deck coming up or something?
Yes. Okay. Speedroids or Psyframes or whatever they're called.
Both of them. They're
still yeah, Speedroids and Psyframes.
But that doesn't matter to our next agenda, though. We'll get to that later.
Okay.
Insight
Magician.
I'm not sure how that deck works. Anthony would know more about this. But I'm thinking that's like the main searcher, and it gave them stupid amounts of advantage, so.
Yeah, I guess we lack insight on this one.
Yes, quite so. Oh.
Yeah, you can choose one Pendulum Magician and place it in your Pendulum Zone.
Okay, so yeah, that gave them stupid amounts of advantage.
Yeah.
Sure, it was to hit Necroz even more, nailing the coffin, because I think Bryonek is at one over there?
Unicorn is definitely at one.
Unicorn and Bryo? What? I thought it was just Bryonek.
No, I remember.
Unicorn's at one.
I think they just give him so much, you know, like Cataster what's it called? The dragon and the old man and the deck is unstoppable, you know, just because it got like one rung lower doesn't mean it wasn't still a very good, abusable ritual deck.
Cycles at one too.
Okay.
It's pretty, I don't know, I think they're doing the same thing to Necros as they're doing to Shadals, where like they just brought it to hell. They're like, oh, they go, can you bring it back? No, you can't. Okay.
It'll be back in like a year and a half.
Maybe.
What's going on with Deep Sea Diva? I think we kind of skipped over. What the heck is a Deep Sea Diva? And what does she do? And is she single?
Well, it's a key card in Mermails.
That's awesome.
So, let me check out the effect real quick. I think it's the pitch cards.
No, Deep Sea Diva brings out...
level 3 or lower.
Yeah, it's just like a tour guide, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sea serpents.
Yeah. I don't even think Mermails are topping. I don't know why they hit this randomly, or maybe it's not random.
Well, they got that structure deck.
That's the prince, but like it wasn't like or doing crazy well. Crazy well.
They got that.
Sorry, quick note: both Unicorn and Brio's at one.
Oh, so both.
Yeah.
Okay. Unicorn, Brio, and Shred's at one.
Yeah.
And Cycle.
All right, let's chill. But yeah. Shred's just still at three.
But yeah.
What is this nonsense? So yeah, she'd bring out free cards. From like she'd bring out an Atlantean, right. And then she'd generate free advantage, basically from that Atlantean through Synchro Summoning or Xyz, and then it links with another hit they did to Mermail. It wasn't a real hit to Mermail. It was just they're bringing back Abysseus, which we'll talk about, to 2.
Yeah.
So that's why Deep Sea Diva's at 1.
Whoa. Suns Bro says that Mermails were topping more than Shadals and Tellers. I think I saw a pie chart about that. Like, only 2 Shadals in the last OCG event or whatever. Only 2 Shadals at top, but they were like 4 or 5, something like that.
Shadal, they construct span in Japan.
Okay.
Did I ever tell you about the Instant Fusion and Genix Undyne combo? Yeah,
it's a +4.
It's like a +1,000,000, actually.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Another reason to hit Instant Fusion, I'm telling you guys.
Well, Norden's bad now, so
that's just Norden.
Yeah, Norden.
Last go to semi-limited.
A trip. Self-explanatory.
Yeah, the Kraws die. We've seen you enough. No more, please. Okay. I'm thinking they saw the worlds and were thinking about it because they thought it was neutered. So neutered to the point that it shouldn't be played. But somehow it still saw play, so.
Real quick though, they didn't hit Tellers in this list. I'm pissed, dude.
Tellers is in a deck over there.
Man, what world, man?
Oh, that world, you're right. Well, that's right, huh? That world. Yeah, that's right.
They made it stronger, I'll explain later. But moving on to semis. Curry Bandit's at 2. Abyss 2 is at 2. Ivagishki. Gus Kraken's at 2. Mind Control's at 2. Book of Moon's at 2. Charge of Light Brigade's at 2. Gold Sarcophagus is at 2. Lore of Darkness at 2. Dragon Shrine is at 2. Gateway of the Six at 2.
Well, the plus card, or the draw cards.
Yeah. Sinister Shadow Games at 2. And Crush Card Virus at 2.
Oh, wow.
So, Curry Bandits was limited.
Good question. When did they limit Curry Bandit? For Lights 1s or what?
It's around
Shadal era.
Oh, okay.
It's near the end of Dragon, when Dragon was super big.
He's so cute. Let's bring him back. Arr, I'm a pirate.
So pretty much all these were at 1, pretty much.
Oh, okay.
Beforehand. But Gateway brings back bad memories.
Gateway was at 1. Oh, over. Let's go down the list. So Curry Bandit going into 2. I don't know. I don't think it matters. Shadal is not the deck over there. I guess maybe BA, since BA is at full power, right?
Yeah, but that doesn't do Curry Bennett's Mills doesn't do BA any favors.
I don't know. So
he's on the board on the thing.
Yeah. So yeah, I guess it come back. I don't know why that too. Abysseus. I guess it makes sense with Diva at 1.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah.
Gus Kraken.
I don't know. That's Gishki card, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The loop. I don't know how the loop works, so I'm not too familiar with that. I never hit TCG, so if any of you guys know anything about that.
I don't really know myself.
Pyre just has no reason to be on the limit of this, so you might as well put it at 2, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, Mind Control at 2, that's pretty crazy.
I think that's pretty brokes too. Same with Book of Moon.
Yeah, Book of Moon at 2 is pretty crazy too.
Well, I think the thing about Mind Control maybe is just promotes fewer mirror matches.
No, I don't think.
Or promotes more mirror matches. What would that do?
It wrecks the mirror match.
It's a sack. I know. But it's whoever gets it first. That's why they maybe they want to throw some sack factor in there. Some sactor.
I don't know.
Not necessarily. I'll get to it when we get to the next topic. Long story short, Monarch becoming a thing that doesn't hurt Monarchs.
Yeah, I mean.
Can't be attributed.
Yeah, can be attributed. But then it
every other deck, I understand.
It likes Mind Control. Promotes OTKs. Like, you have a big monster on board, and like, oh, I'll just take it and attack with game.
I can vouch.
Take it and attack with another monster per game. Not the same one.
I did this for Yu-Gi-Oh! Day. I can vouch.
Yeah, so yeah, it's pretty rocks. Book of Moon's 1-2 is pretty good. It's the best +1 in the game, in my opinion.
It's also, I see as a hit.
Book of Moon's a +1?
It's a minus 1. The best minus 1. Best minus 1.
I see as a hit to BA, in a sense.
Oh, okay, yeah, I agree there.
They just released all the BA stuff. Hey guys, what did you?
I wish we would get Pokemon
too. What'd you guys get in the case? I don't.
Dante. Only worthy is Dante.
Going next. Charge.
Match these fiends.
So charge to 2. I think it's gonna help.
Charge is at 2 here.
Yeah.
Right?
So.
Yeah, I think it's gonna help other decks.
Yeah.
Not Lightsworn.
Come on, dude, you have Minerva, though. Minerva.
The easy Minerva, not the prize card Minerva. Yeah. And then Goldstark at 2, I mean, Ritual Beast is pretty good, right?
I guess.
Well, it's just, the way I've always saw Goldstark was just a Universal Searcher, you know? So that's why I think it's pretty good. It's just good for thinning, but with Rit Beast, yeah, it's sometimes even better because not only is it's a Universal Searcher, it's also a Universal Banisher. It's like a Foolish target, yeah, it's like their own version of Foolish, so.
Yeah.
Pretty good. Maybe, I don't think that they'd be trying to promote Rit Beast over there, too.
Maybe, I don't know. Moving on to Lure of Darkness, the 2. This hasn't been at 2 since like 2009 when I first started like playing competitively with Destiny Draw and Lure of Darkness. So I believe it should stay at 1. Like maybe the drawing 2 doesn't matter anymore. Maybe they think like, oh, there's too many pluses. Like, what is a neutral? But yeah.
Well, what's a really strong dark deck going on in Japan? Maybe that's the thing too. Maybe like since there's no dark decks, it's just promote like, geez, guys, people haven't been playing, you know, zombies in a while. Let's give them a Lure of Darkness at 2 or something.
Burning Abyss.
Yeah. Burning Abyss. Well, Burning Abyss. David, you didn't play a Lure of Darkness, right?
I don't think it depends. I mean, if you're playing control, you want to play a Lure of Darkness. But I would say, not sure how the meta is gonna work over in Japan. But the way it seems, from what I've gathered, it's so much more faster. I think they'd be playing Turbo. Be over there, in which case Lure may be unnecessary.
Because you don't want to banish your dark monster, right? You're not trying to dig for anything.
You should already have a handful of B monsters. Why would you want to throw away a Farf for a Skarm, you know?
Yeah.
I actually saw a deck list that got first place, and it actually seemed pretty trap heavy in comparison, so
really?
It was a little weird. Yeah, it's like I don't have it on me right now, but I did see it, and for some reason it was like extremely trap heavy, and they didn't run a lot of monsters. They only ran the triple Skarm, triple Grav, triple Sur, and it was a little confusing.
If that's the case, then maybe this would just be to promote people playing more BAs.
It might.
Just to get people to dig into their traps, I guess. I mean, Japan is fortunate in that they get to. You know, they got to see for a whole year what BA could do and what type of builds you could make with it, and then, you know, now they can just test it and test their own matchups.
Well, it's like kind of like us, we get to see them play it first, right? So now they get to reverse for them, they can see us play it.
Yeah, true, true.
I think it's fair.
Yeah.
Dragon Shrine, the 2, I think all the Dragon rules are all banned over there, right?
Yes.
So I don't think this matters at all. So moving on. Gateway to 6, this is pretty crazy. Gateway to 6 at 2, we have it at 0, right?
Yeah.
I don't know, it's 6 sounds, man.
This is the one that gets you counters every time you summon.
Any summon at all.
Anytime you summon a 6 samurai monster, you get a token, and then you get a draw?
No, you get a search.
Or
get one from grave. So you have 2 on board, it's pretty much infinite loop. You should be able to summon as many monsters as you can.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's pretty crazy.
Shao games.
The two, right?
Yeah.
I mean, Contract is dead, so... Whoever's playing this deck in Japan is like, oh, good for you, man.
Hey, more power to you, man. Hey, you get that Hedgehog flip, man. You get that Hedgehog search.
No, get that one Elsa doll. Get that one Elsa doll.
Do it, man. Do it.
Yeah.
And Crush, because it's got neutered pretty much.
Yeah, I don't think... People aren't even playing 1, you know? Over here in TCG, people aren't playing 1, because it kind of helps the opponent more than it hurts them, so...
The only deck that really could play Crush card, BA... You know, in the meta, our meta, it would just help either Shadal.
Hold on a second there. Crush card actually hits the Pendulum decks pretty hard.
Yeah.
And then it also hits the Monarchs as well. So.
But then the new Pendulum decks aren't big monsters. Only 3s were big monsters. But it is true with the Monarchs. I do agree. But the Monarchs, are they... We'll get to it, but I'm not... It's not out yet, right? Or is it out?
It's out. It came out.
Okay, we'll talk about that in a bit.
If you crush card a pendulum monster from the hand,
they go to grave. Not
okay. Yeah.
Well, hey, wait, one last thing. Is there's a Zerata as well?
Yeah,
there's Zerata. They came in first. Move on to Unlimited, Bowie.
Unlimited. So Bowman's at 3. Goddamn Ana's at 3. Kia's Emperor Dragon, neutered version's at 3. Demok's at 3, neutered version. Oh. Gale's at 3. Manju's now back at 3. Institution's back at 3. Magical Stone Excavation's at 3. The Transmigration Prophecy's at 3. Bombless at 3.
Whoa!
Formula at 3 and Wind Up Care is in Mighty's at 3. So, quick note, Bubble Man was at 2, Honest was at 2, Chaos Emperor was at 1, D-Mock was at 1, Gale was at 2, Manju was at 2, Formula was at 2, Wind Up was at 2, Insta was at 1, Magical was at 2, Trans Prophecy was at 1, and Bottomless was at 2.
So, first off, with the Bubble Man, with the Dark Gentleman, he has something to stage on?
So, yeah, because Bubble Man is at 3, they needed to hit one of the searchers again. I don't think they have Rhoda at 3. So, yeah, Shadow Mist and... Huh?
I believe it's at 2, you're right.
It's still at 2, but they still only have 4 ways of searching more Bubble Man, which is just Shadow Mist and Stratos. So, it's pretty much the main reason why Shadow Mist was hit. So, with Shadow Mist at 1, the reasoning was that Bubble Man can be back at 3.
Yeah, I do agree that Shadow Mist is a stronger card than Bubble Man. So the flip was right if you're trying to hurt the deck, but not too hard. So I do agree. Mm-hmm. So an Honest at 3.
God damn it, dude. Terra's supposed to get neutered, not buffed.
Yeah.
Oh, hey.
So Bujins, man, the more we see more Jeff Jones going around. The Jeff Jones nuke. I don't know, man. Honest is pretty crazy.
I think Jonas is just nuts.
I have bad flashbacks.
Like, yeah, it wins games by itself.
Dude, I played that when like Lightsworn had everything at 3, dude. That was the worst feeling ever.
Because you never know you're safe to attack. And it's so scary. And then, Chaos Emperor to 3?
Super neutered.
Don't forget, this is bad. I found what it did, but I just know that it wasn't broke anymore.
Isn't it still pretty good, the Chaos Emperor Dragon?
No, it is total garbage. Like,
isn't it still a 2,000 beater?
It's still a 3k beater, but you might as well just run BLS at that point.
Why don't you play Blue Eyes there?
It's free, though.
I don't know how it works.
Just run BLS.
Oh, yeah, of course you run BLS, but you can run Emperor Dragon, too. It's like a 3,000 meter, man. It's broken as hell.
I guess.
Did we ever get a Rata in America? No, not right? Yet. Yeah.
It didn't get a reprint from Premium Gold 2.
Oh, okay, that's why.
We're still waiting for D-Mock and Chaos.
Oh, so D-Mock's the last one, right?
Yeah.
D-Mock and Chaos, okay.
They got Rod.
Yeah, so it's talking about D-Mock. It got Rod recently, too, D-Mock. It wasn't with the rest of them. It wasn't with the ring set. Ring,
Gold, Premium Gold?
Yeah, it was Ring, Crush Card, Merrick's cards, Chaos Emperor, and all
Exchange of the Spirit.
Exchange of the Spirit. All those cards got reprinted, got Rod at the same time, and then D-Mock just got recently rerotted, where you add the spell card in the end phase if it still lives. So I think that's really bad.
Yeah, Gale's at 3. I think you're happy about that.
I mean, it was a 3 in America. It doesn't matter.
No, now we know that if it doesn't get touched, next year's Worlds.
Oh, yeah, next year's Worlds. Yep. It's going to be Blackwings, man. I'm telling you guys. Why you guys play Blackwings? It would have won. And then... Mondra 3 doesn't matter because Necros. I mean. Yeah.
Oh, but Gishkis.
Oh, Gishkis, yeah.
And BA.
Insta at 3 helps. Like, generic rank 4, 3, whatever toolbox.
Yeah, I didn't realize that they did this. Yeah, now it makes sense why. They could have gone one of both ways, right? They could have banned Norden or Insta. I guess Insta was already at 1, so now they just went Norden 9, Insta 3.
Yeah.
They could have did 3 Norden and 1 Insta. Or no Instas.
Magical Stones at 3, not really doing anything in this meta.
Yeah. I think only decks to play would be like, faggot, I mean, sorry. FTK decks. I'm sorry.
Hey, you trying to talk to-
Transmigration Prophecy, that's the one that it shuffles back 2 cards, right?
Yeah.
So that's pretty good, because I mean, the way I had remembered it, you can play Transmigration Prophecy as like a Fiend Griefing or as like a DD Crow. Technically, because it targets in the grave. So, I mean, I think that's pretty relevant, especially being at 3 now. I don't know if people are actually going to play it, because not a lot of things are being recycled from the grave like they used to be, like, you know, dragons and stuff like that were, but I think that's pretty cool. I wish we had a 3.
In our format, I don't think you want to put cards back into your opponent's deck, unless you're targeting, like, Falco Target. Like, you want to put a Construct back or, like, a Beast back so they can draw more. So, I don't know. I'm pretty sure it's not going to do anything. But the next big card is Bottomless, which is pretty big, because the Exceed card, right, John?
Yeah. The Phantom...
No.
Phantom Knights of the Breaks.
No, no, not that one.
Oh, not that one?
The Trap Tricks.
Oh, you mean Trap Tricks Rafflesia?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one's broke, too.
with Triple Bottomless?
Yes.
She's so good. I miss her. I wish we got her.
How could you miss someone you never met?
Oh.
Yeah, obviously you never fall in love.
Oh!
He's right.
Savage.
Savage.
What's love?
No,
don't hurt me no more.
Rafisha was a generic rainforest, right? Or is it two earth level fours?
I believe it's generic.
Well, I think it was generic. And then the way it works is you can detach it, and then you can send a bottomless card from your deck to your grave.
Trap hole. A hole.
What did I say?
Bottomless card.
My bad. A trap hole card. And then that that effect becomes the effect of the hole card. So meaning she can be anything she wants. Basically, you can play Trap Tricks pure at that point, you know, which is pretty cool. You probably wouldn't. You probably should sprinkle it with some other rainforest shenanigans, but... I think that it was gonna reinvigorate like the Trap Tricks engine. I was really excited about it until I found out that it was gonna be OCG exclusive.
Yeah, it's pretty broke. Not gonna lie.
Yeah,
it's she can be anything she wants to be, just like life.
Okay, assuming she.
Yeah,
comes...
you go, girl.
Okay.
You go, girl.
She's like a white man. She can be anything he wants.
Oh, and Formula Synchron.
No, it doesn't matter.
And Wind-Up Carriers in Mighty.
I don't know, is any other Wind-Up cards limited or banned in OCG land?
I'm on it. A Hunter's banned.
Hunter, that's fine.
Yeah, that's the loop.
Yeah, no Wind-Up loop, but I think Wind-Up's still a pretty good deck. Like, you don't need a loop to win. Like, people didn't play loop when they played it at Nats and stuff. They just played straight up Wind-Ups. What do you say?
Zen Mighty's the bad one, that's one that's banned here.
Yeah, she's banned. Yeah, they're banned.
Zen Mighty?
Yeah, Zen Mighty's banned. So you would detach, you go Tour Guide, make Zen Mighty, detach, make the rat, and then you get your engine going after that.
Hmm.
Yep, so any last words for the ban list, guys?
Not really.
You should hit Tour Guide, see how it's like.
Is that three and is that
yeah.
three over?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's still three.
So BA is full power.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, what I would give.
And you get Beatrice there too.
Yeah.
David's a retired BA player. Just cause tour guide.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey man, it still works.
So are we done with OCG ban list?
Yep.
So we're still in OCG land, but let's talk about our sponsors.
With the sponsors.
Not Core TCG.
Well, yeah. We shouldn't even say their name out loud because that's technically free publicity.
Okay, fine. Not Costco.
How about this? How about we call them Board
TCG? It's all you, man. You make it up.
GCT.
Board GCT. You stupid.
I'm fine with it, dude. This is all you. Explain later. So, next topic, the Monarch deck. Normally, I wouldn't talk about like other stuff outside OCG, other than like banlists. But this deck is stupid!
Yes, yeah.
This starter deck. So...
Oh, I get anything. Yeah, Kaya's too, that's pretty cool.
So... Came out... Was it, sorry, last Friday-ish area? The news came... Yeah. The leak came out 16th, so that runs for 80. 41 cards and a 42nd token.
What?
So they get 41 cards and a token. Yeah, sorry.
What's the token look like?
Such value.
I don't know. I didn't see.
What is the token of?
I don't know. I didn't see.
Oh.
It's a token, though.
Cool.
Yeah, dude, though, we have to, like, win Yu-Gi-Oh! Day and stuff to get tokens. They just buy it.
Yeah,
seriously.
Well.
Legendary world. Legendary Joey's world.
Cheap tokens.
Yeah. Okay, John, you want to go
over Yu-Gi-Oh! World gave you MSA.
Alright, so... I'll go over the names.
It's sponsored by Domino's? I wish, dude.
Alright, so the first monster. What? The first monster in the structure deck is Aether the Heaven Monarch. It's an ultra rare. So he's a level 8.
Sorry.
Huh?
You don't have to talk about it. We're talking
We don't have to talk about it now? Okay,
yeah,
so.
We'll go over it quick.
Yeah, so.
Just, I guess, in short, you know, this deck pretty much can turn a mono deck, which I think the biggest problem is because it needs to be tributed. You needed some type of engine, like the Frog engine, to allow you to tribute it. Now that has gotten a bunch of support cards that eliminate that factor. Most cards are top deckable. A lot of there's a searcher in there that lets you search twice, so that's pretty broke. I had the displeasure of playing one of these on Dev Pro, and I didn't know what was going on. All I know is that, like, my butt really hurt by the end of the match, so.
Let's all go over the names.
Quick.
The deck list, John, sorry.
Alright, so it's Aether the Heaven Monarch, Erebus the Netherworld Monarch, Eidos the Netherworld Knight, Idea the Heaven Knight, Kaius the Shadow Monarch, Zuborg the Thunder Monarch, Grandmark the Rock Monarch, Mobius the Frost Monarch, Thestalus the Firestorm Monarch, Rise of the Storm Monarch, Lucius the Shadow Vassal, Mithril the Thunder Vassal, Landrobe the Rock Vassal, Escher the Frost Vassal, Berlines the Firestorm Vassal, Garum the Storm Vassal, Illusory Snatcher, Trigodia, Dandelion, Mathematician, Level Eater, Battle Fader, Rainbow Karibo, Pandeity Monarchs, Dominion of the Legendary Monarch, March of the Monarchs, Return of the Monarchs, The Monarch Storm Forth, Strike of the Monarchs, Tenacity of the Monarchs, Soul Exchange, Enemy Controller, Mystical Space Typhoon, Soul Charge, The Original Monarch, The First Monarch, Escalation of the Monarchs, The Monarchs Awaken, The Monarchs Erupt, By Order of the Emperor, and Pinpoint Guard.
Shipping the Order of the Monarch.
The vassals are like level 4 tribute fodder for the monarchs, right?
One, two, three.
They're variable.
Four, yeah.
But whatever, they're tribute fodder, right? That's what they are?
Honestly, you don't even need those, because there's literally a build with just the first four monsters, and that's all you ever need.
What's the rest? Just a bunch of Monarch Stormfords?
You're gonna, like, you need the first four monsters, like, three of each. So that's, you're like, 12 monsters already. Then you have all the searcher cards, like Tenacity. You also have Pandeity and a bunch of other Monarch cards that pretty much helmet you. And then you also have the Original Monarch, which is a very good trap card, by the way. So I'll tell you what the Original Monarch does. You can target two Monarch spell trap cards, shuffle them into deck, and then draw a card. So that's already generating advantage for you. And then if the card is in your graveyard, you can banish one other Monarch spell trap from your graveyard and special summon this card in defense position as a normal monster. And it's not even a trap card, so it doesn't belong to a zone. You can't MST it. So basically that card generates free advantage.
Are the vassals, are they new or are they old?
They're new.
Majority are new.
So majority of this deck is pretty new, right? Like the first four cards are vassals, some of the spells and traps, or one of
some of the vassals, anyways.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
Plus, there's just so many good reprints here. Like, this is such a value structure deck. I can't see anybody not buying three of these.
Mathman's here.
I know, right?
I'll buy just for Mathman's.
Mathman's.
You buy for Lucius, dude. Look at that face.
Level Eater,
Dandelion, Lucius,
Battle Fader. This is just a great chest deck. Great job, Konami, I gotta say.
No,
great job.
The problem is, will they port card for card when it comes to TCG?
That's true.
I mean, if they want to make money, I think they would. I would say.
They did it last time with the
Heroes.
No, not Heroes. It was the fairy one. It was supposed to come with Christia, but it didn't come with Christia.
No, there's like supposed to have Nidabug's Nest reprint and Lightsworn.
Oh, yeah, that one
came
too.
Like a 10 buck card, dude.
Yeah, it wasn't in there either.
Transmodify was supposed to be in Transmodify was supposed to be in Cyber Dragons.
Yep, that one too.
You're right. I could actually see them not giving us Mathman, because then you got some more premium golds and Dragons of Legends. Unlimited.
Yep. So that's pretty much it.
Yeah. Stupid deck.
Is it? It's top tier there, right?
In, it's tier one.
Is it tier?
Yeah, it's tier one. Cause like
this and Magicians are topping.
And also BA, so.
Ice Cream Magicians.
Top 3 split? Or what's is it more Ice Cream stuff, or is it more
Monarch? Mostly Ice Cream for now.
It's like RPS, yeah.
Okay.
It's like Ice Cream, then like followed by, the thing.
Monarchs?
Yes.
And then BA?
Yeah.
What's Soul Charge doing in that deck list, by the way?
I don't know, it's there.
You play Soul Charge, and then you tribute 2, and then you get Mega Monarch effect.
But Eidos, he summons Idea from the graveyard, so you can just... And then Idea summons Eidos from the deck.
Wow, that's a great idea.
Moving on?
Let's move on.
Let's talk about our next sponsor.
Costco, where the low goes.
It's Costco, where the cost is low, man.
Get it right, man. This is my sponsor we're talking about.
Dude, like $2 for a hot dog and a drink?
Too good.
Dude, yeah, I thought it was 150.
Costco has probably, fueled a lot of duelists through a lot of late night duels, so.
No, dude, they closed food courts early.
Oh, shit. Why you gotta talk bad about the sponsors on air, man?
This is how we get little sponsors, man. What are you doing?
They knew what they got themselves into when they took out my favorite item.
What's your favorite item?
Carne asada?
Huh? Yes, carne asada.
Wait, what?
Carne asada bake?
Yeah.
You had that?
Yeah.
Chicken bake with carne asada. But it was like, I think it was like 1,800 or 2,000 calories.
Whoa. Man, yeah, I didn't know that. Good.
They did it for your own good, man.
Hey, man, it takes a true hero like that to save a life, or potentially millions of lives.
So, let's get to the next topic. God damn it. 17th, ARG got an interesting leak. A random source gave them pretty much the picture of the sheet, and two cards we saw was Cosmo's Lightsword. Now, this card we have no knowledge of the effect, but from what I see from the picture, it looks like a common.
That's pretty cool.
And it is equipped spell.
Yeah.
And it looks like a lightsaber.
Of course. And you see right there, Good Witch is getting shanked in the midsection.
Wow.
For all we know, though, it could be like bamboo sword, for all we know.
Qui-Gon Jinn. Literally Qui-Gon Jinn.
But you need it for like another effect, you know what I mean? For all we know, I'm just saying. I'm theorizing here. It could totally be useless, and then, you know what I mean? Or it could be a broke equip like Sacrifice, so we'll see.
Or it could be like a Noble Knight equipped card where it just keeps coming back.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I think it's going to have a banish effect, like all you banishes in the grave to add like something. I think that's what's gonna do.
I mean, normally I don't like leaks, but I like the fact that this was a leak with no effect, because my personal thing is I like it when people jump on the forums and talk, share ideas, and this definitely got a lot of people going. I think I saw this on Facebook, and there were like, you know, like thousands of comments and shares and likes, and I like that. I like when people talk about the.
It feels like a Konami leak, right? Konami did on purpose.
Like, yeah.
Well, actually, it was like, man, my dad works at Konami. I can tell you effect right now.
Then your dad gets fired somehow. So it's suddenly it's like, oh crap.
Did they confirm that this leak came from ARG?
No, like, the ARG is the first one to post it.
Oh, they just posted it. Because I was going to say, those guys are like really on Konami's bad side.
That's why the guy sent to them.
No, it's like, it was like a total FU, like, hey, posting everything and we're on our own ban list. And we sell OTS cards and we don't care. And we make money.
And we make money.
Well, yeah, speaking of ARG, quick heads up. Forgot Death Pro has the ARG format now if you want to test that. Doesn't matter for us because we West Coast, but...
That's just Death Pro giving in to the week.
Or making Death Pro making a quick buck because they don't really care about
ARG. Good for you, man. You're a smart guy.
You think they got paid?
Maybe.
I doubt they get paid.
I mean, it's a super easy program.
We'll see. Yeah, we'll see.
Next thing on the list?
Other card. It's Cosmol. There's like two L's at the end. Wicked Witch, dude.
I believe it's Cosmo.
No, it's... whatever, two L's. But from what I saw, because of stupid lighting, this is the best I could get. During either's blank, you could banish this card.
During either player's turn, I think.
Dude, I don't know, man!
We should have the same...
It should be one for one with Good Witch.
With the other Good Witch and...
Hey, this is your show, boy.
Special summon one level 5 or blank, Cosmo monster from your hand.
Higher.
I think it's higher, man. It's got something good for you guys.
Real fortune. You gotta say it all out.
I like to solve the puzzle, Pat.
You can only use this effect of Cosmo Wicked Witch once per turn. That's all I can see.
It's a psychic, and it's almost
not rare, though. I can tell it's not rare.
Oh, it's dark. Interesting. This is the first time we're seeing dark art.
So seeing this, we actually see BLS being ran in Cosmos now, if there's going to be more darks coming out.
Yeah.
Because then you see the card next to it. I don't know. Is it the same card? I don't think so.
Wait a second. I don't think you may or may not see BLS, because you won't see too many monsters in the grave. The most banished.
True. But then BLS brings them to the banished.
I know, but you never have them in the grave to begin with.
Because they banish themselves.
Yeah, you could if they die. Like, farm girl dies.
Yeah, they get fucked up. Yeah,
they get fucked up, yeah. Yo, you see the car next to Cosmo? Which on this picture?
To the left? The left? Yeah, like some dark thing.
Yeah.
Like it might be too dark.
Like, yeah. If you compare it to the door to the tall car on the left, like you see how the darkness thing? It could be like a TIE fighter.
Oh, okay.
Oh, so interesting.
Vader ship or Maul ship?
So I think what's gonna happen is Cosmo are gonna be lights, and then Cosmo or Maul are gonna be darks.
Yeah. That's pretty good prediction. Obvious prediction.
You got good. You got well, that's what it's all about. It's all about. So you got a good witch and a wicked witch, and then you got a farm girl. You might got a bad girl or a naughty girl. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. The leaks.
She's gonna make a leak, girl.
Girls. So, we'll see.
Yeah, man. If they push it as hard as they did with BA, where like everything they did had purpose, I think this deck's gonna be really good because BA did really good. But like, there's always that one TCG deck that did really bad, which is like, you know, UA and like Noble Knights. So yeah, I think this is the good side. This is gonna be the good TCG exclusive.
Yeah.
What the other two did we get? Oh no, Kaiju's. Never mind. You're right.
They only have two cards. Well, three cards.
Oh, they're on their way.
It'd be like
I guarantee 2.0. They're gonna get out Logia and Evilsaur. Watch.
Maybe.
Logia?
The evil tile, the Evilsaur.
Yeah, evil tile, yeah.
They have to make. Louis, they use 2 level 4 dinosaur monsters.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant like some sort of kaiju. Like legit monster. Whatever. Next topic. Next sponsor.
You guys have this many sponsors?
Yeah, man. Febreze. So, you know, you guys bring your deck, your binder, and your sleeves. But you guys need to bring your Febreze. Because you guys smell.
A lot of you guys smell.
So, also the same day, Konami decided to announce giant news. So, here's the webpage. I'll give you the too long didn't read version. So, starting with Breakers of Shadow, January 15, 2016, they changed the ratio, so every pack guaranteed a hollow foil. So it's either a super, an ultra, or a secret. So the pull rates now is for ultra, it used to be 1 to 12, now it's 1 to 6. And a secret, it used to be 1 to 23, and now it's 1 to 12. In addition, they announced that Ultimates, rarities is only available for Astral Packs or like the Tournament Packs. And that Ghost Rares will no longer be made as of right now, but they might come back in the future. Because it's awkward for them, because it's one of the most expensive foils to print.
And so they don't want
to raise prices of packs.
Yeah, no one's really like cared about a Ghost Rare since, Jottle. That's Judgment of the Light. I call it Jottle.
I call it Jottle.
It was Star Eater.
Star Eater? Oh,
yeah. That was like the last.
No, Felgrand.
No.
Oh yeah,
no, that was Shadow Spectres. I think that was before. That was before.
No, that was after. That was after Jottle.
Oh no, I don't know my sets.
Well, in my opinion, I was making a video about this, but like, I don't think this matters because they can just add more supers.
More shit supers,
yeah, and more shit secrets. And
that's actually bad.
Yeah, it's actually bad. So. I mean, I guess in the good side is actually you can't scale up packs anymore because you get one super in every pack.
Yeah, and I guess the other good thing is if they are going to keep boxes at 24 packs per box, you're going to get 2 secrets, you know? So, I mean, you might increase your chances of getting a good secret, but as Dennis said, if they end up doing what we don't want to do, which is printing out more
shit cards,
shit secrets and shit ultras, this is actually going to be a lot worse because it's gonna be hard to get those good cards now, you know. If it's essentially every good card will be a short print secret, right?
Yeah.
So think about it, like in Japan, all their good cards are like commons and rares. Then that's, you know, for a good reason because they don't, you know, if they had made everything super secret and ulti and ghost over there, they'd never pull anything good out of 5 cards.
Yeah, and I think that what they said about the cost of a ghost rare. Like, it's really expensive. I think that's complete bullshit.
It seems cheaper than anything because there's no
ink. No, dude, because it's special inking, dude. It's like, was it Miracle or some shit?
But so there's multiple layering in Ghost Rare.
I know, but you're
it
saying...
It makes it seem holographic.
You're saying it's... They're saying that it's 1 in 233, right? That you get a Ghost Rare?
1 288.
So 1 out of 288. So you're saying 288 supers are cheaper than 1 Ghost Rare? Is that what you guys are saying? You know? If you do the math, I don't think that adds up, man.
If anything... Here's what I will say. I think ultimate rares are kind of ugly. Very rarely do they ever look good. But ultimate rares, definitely cost more than Ghost Rares. I don't even know anything about math or science or printing. I don't know anything about that. But I could just look at an Ultra Rare and say, oh yeah, that costs more than a Ghost Rare. There's borders! And the stars are colored and everything is just so colorful. Ulti is definitely the most expensive one to print.
Yeah, so I don't know.
But I think that's a cool thing because Ultimate Rares, I mean, just the name, Ultimate Rare, would make you think that it's hard to get, not one in every box, you know? So the fact that they're leaving that exclusively for Astral Packs and other tournament prizes and tournament packs, I think is really cool because it encourages more people to go out to their locals, like Magic and Monsters and not Board TCG, to enter
CTG.
CTG to you know, pay $5-6 to enter the locals, you know? I think people should do that more often.
Warning, this stream does not express the views of Bui, Dennis, and
I think also the thing about America is different from Japan and other countries is that we love our shiny shit. Like, David has a gold iPhone just because it's gold. Because it's shiny. I think we just like our shiny.
I'm an Android guy, but it was gold. So.
Yeah, so people just like shiny. Like, it's just... Konami's smart on that part. Like, they know that people like shiny. It doesn't matter if it's shit or good. People like shiny. So... Good for them.
Yeah. I'm just hoping that, like, you know, like, with the supers, they'll do something smart with it, you know?
Tony said that Ghost Rares are actually 3D imaging.
I don't know how much it costs, but I'm pretty sure it won't
cost. I just said that. Like, I told you it's multiple layering.
Okay,
all due respect, Antonio, you know, when I go to the gumball machine, I put in a quarter, it gives me a little holographic sticker that's like Ghost Rare. I don't think that costs that much. It's like a quarter, you know? Yeah. But that's neither here nor there. Sorry, but what I was saying before was... I hope that with this giving out a super, at least a super every pack, I hope they take advantage of this by printing out good supers, because I know people love to haul out their decks, right? So even like something like a Tanky or something like a Rota will come out, like, you know, archetype stuff that you can use for your deck. They shouldn't waste a common or a rare on that. They should make those supers. That makes sense.
Suns Bros want to know what happened with quarter TCG. We'll explain that when we get to regionals.
Sun Bros, there will be a video coming out soon. PDF's official
release
disbandment.
Release? Oh no, disbandment. Not
disbandment
release.
From my promotional sponsorship with Court TCG. Board TCG.
Unofficial.
Sorry. I think if they really super in every pack, I think they should do how Pokemon does it and Magic does it. How every card in the set. Every card comes hollow.
So, every card comes hollowed, super or common.
So you can get every card hollow, and you get your whole deck hollow.
Oh, like Starfoil rares.
No, Starfoil rares.
No,
Starfoil. Yeah, you're right. The whole set is common. Yeah. What do you say, John?
No, never mind. I was about to say something else. Never mind.
Yeah. I'm sorry I cut you off.
That's cool.
I apologize for Dennis cutting you off.
So yeah, I think they did that. That'll be really nice. But... as of right now, we don't know what the ratio is going to do. We're not Konami.
Yeah.
But I highly doubt their thing. They said that it's cheaper to print. No, not print Ghost Rares and more Supers. I think that's bullshit. But you know, whatever.
People, I think this is a smart move.
Yeah.
I tell you what, as a person that spends money on Yu-Gi-Oh cards, I know a lot of kids don't. They just trade and stuff like that. I go out to Target, and when I see that goddamn foil pack staring in my face, I think, today the day? Today's the day, and I give them $4, and you know, I give them $4.28, and I pop open that pack, and I'm like, is this the day? And then I don't see any foils, you know? But now, every day is the day, and every day I'm gonna see a foil.
No, dude, now you got one up. It's the day where I get the secret.
Yeah, so this is tough now. So, I mean, every day, probably every time I go to Target.
The challenge is not going to be the same then. Cause...
it's going to change. I mean, as the Juju Master, I will have to play around. I'll probably have to spend a couple $1,000 testing it to figure out how ratios work and how Juju's going to move, how it's going to work moving forward. But, like, I think it's going to work. Like, it should boost sales, which is what they want. I, as a person that buys loose packs and buys blister packs, I'm going to say right now, oh, hell yeah, I'm going to buy more blister packs now. I don't need to waste money on a box. I can just buy $4 blister packs.
Okay. So, quick notes, sorry. This is going to be a preview of what to expect in High Speed Riders, which comes out October 2nd. 60-card mini set with High Speed Roids and Psyframes. So you can test out there.
Hold on a sec. They're going to try out the new pack format in High Speed Riders.
Yeah.
But that makes no sense. High Speed Riders is like, what's it called? A Secret Forces set.
Yeah.
That's that. No, they're going to put a rare in there now.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
And the Mention of Chaos will be the last set to feature Ultimates and Ghosts in the booster.
For sure.
We should probably buy those Ghosts, right? Because it's a piece of history. Guys, it's a piece of history. We should
Declaration of Independence.
I know. I don't care. It could be like a ghost rare, you know, junk card, you know, but we're going to buy all of them because it means something.
Yeah.
The ghosts are dying, guys. The ghosts are dying.
We're going to call.
Ghosts.
What was the ghost rare of last set? Oh, it was the red eyes. So, yeah, it's going to be the main set card. That's going to be ghost,
it's
I feel.
You should need like a ghost Dinko.
Serious?
So
and the last ghost they had that was not in a real set was the MSTs, right? The MST Solemn Gores.
Because they came in the gold Haunted Gold
Mine. Yeah, Haunted Gold Mine. Yeah, that was a while back.
That was awesome, the third ghost series, dude.
Churia Barkeon.
MSTs are freaking expensive.
Yeah, that's totally right. They can totally hype it up. You're right. Because could you imagine Premium Gold 3, by the way?
Return of the Ghost.
I know, Return of the Ghost. Here's a ghost, you know, like...
Oh my god.
Oh my god, Ghost Exodia.
Return of the Ghost.
Do you guys know that they made a Ghost Graffa? How garbage.
Yes, I did. I actually seen that.
Yeah.
That's it, I guess.
That's it, yeah. So moving on.
Let's talk about our last. Oh no, I timed out. Let's talk about sponsors while I do this quick.
What was that?
You timed out. Found out on the end.
Oh.
Yeah. Our last sponsor. You have any sponsors, David?
We have like three more sponsors. Yeah.
Chipotle.
Chipotle's pretty good.
Chipotle's fucking awesome. I had Chipotle yesterday. My brother bought it for me. It was really good.
Shout out to David's brother.
Shout out to David. I probably wouldn't be playing Yu-Gi-Oh! If it wasn't for him. Because he was like, hey, this is a cool game. Could you imagine? Okay, so I'm like 6, 7 years old, and how old I was and however old he was. He's a game called Yu-Gi-Oh! We should go buy some quads. And
Was he born in Brooklyn and you were born in Cali?
Yeah. He got me started on Yu-Gi-Oh! He was like, I'll be Yu-Gi, you be Kaiba.
Why does he eat Joey and you're Kaiba?
They didn't have it back then. This is OG.
Yeah, like,
the structure deck scene.
Yeah. He was Yugi, starter deck Yugi, and I was starter deck Kaiba.
Oh.
Jokes on him, Kaiba has the better
card. Yeah, no, I was reversed, dude. I gave my bird the Yugi one.
Wow, you're a douchebag.
Douchebag, look at the deck I ran at Regionals.
Alright,
so...
Oh, yeah, Regionals. That's total douche.
Speaking of douchebags, Regionals, tell us what you did, douchebag.
So, well, at Regionals for all of us, last Saturday, me, Dennis played, David did side, John did side. So, 10 rounds, 1,002 people, god damn it, why do I live in SoCal?
Makes you stronger.
So, you played, what'd you play?
First of all, let me preface this. I did give snacks at the event.
No, what'd you play?
People who sound say...
No.
Let me get through this first!
Before he sounds like a jerk, he's gotta sound like a nice guy.
People who mentioned P-Stream got free fruit roll-up. Otherwise, I sold chips for a buck. And also, our good friend, the Crimson Chin, got top 4. Congrats to him.
Top 8.
Yeah, I'm sorry. So let's go to the next topic.
I'm happy for Crimson Chin, aka John.
Crimson Chin was 4th.
No, he's 7th.
You can look up the list. His name is Jonathan. You can go look it up.
There's two Jonathans on top
8.
Okay, that makes more sense.
Okay, let's go to the next Jonathan.
So he came in 7th.
He's playing Shadals? Pure Shadals. Right. He was a true believer. You're not.
He was at table 2 and he won. I don't know why he came in 7th. That was pretty crazy.
Tiebreakers.
Oh, you should have been table.
He should have been 2nd. Yeah.
Tiebreakers is stupid, dude.
Yeah.
You expect to see that deck profile later?
Yeah, I expect to see that deck profile later. I don't know if he's going to do it because he's kind of a douchebag right now. He's shy.
No, dude, just get Taco King.
He can just type up the transcript and I'll read it. I'll be the Crimson Jin.
Okay. Alright, so yeah.
Okay, let's
congrats see. To him. Second top. He topped regionals with GBs and then second top, and then he topped nationals with Evil Swarm. So yeah, what you say?
I was gonna say, you know, I hate Shadals, but I've practiced a lot with Jonathan, Crimson Jin playing Shadals, and the way he plays it, it's pure art.
Well deserved.
It's magistry, that man, with his Squamata dumps. It's elegant, so he deserves it, yeah.
Well deserved.
Yeah. I didn't get first. I'm sorry, guys. I failed you. Let's go to the next topic.
Wait, what?
Hey, we gotta talk about you so, being a douche.
Louis, what deck did you play, man?
Why are you showing this douchebag deck on stream right now?
Why do you have a Klee deck? I hate Klee decks. I only losers play Klee decks. Anyways, what did you play?
No, let's just ask P-Bunny first. I'm pretty sure people want to know what he played.
Oh, I played Shadal Clowns. I lost to Infernoids, Douchebag Infernoids, and Douchebag Klees. With towers.
Do you think that the clowns were holding you back?
No, I think it was a good deck. I'm just losing to douchebag decks.
Yeah.
I wasn't losing to anything, I mean, but douchebag decks.
If
so.
You play Infernoids or like Klees, like come on, get out of here, dude. Like
the guy literally reasoning his whole deck.
Take off your helmet and like learn to play the game.
Hey,
Louis,
hey, Infernoid isn't a helmet deck, sir. It is Lightsworn's 3.7.
3.7, where'd you get that number from?
So, Lightsworn's 2.0 was Sylvan's.
Yeah,
so,
true.
Infernoids took it a step further and made it even more BS. So, well, I had to add 1.7 to the 2.
In my experience, Lightsworn players are either really young or really old, like dads. You know what I mean? So, like, that's why it's okay.
They're like, I can't gamble, but I'm gonna gamble with this!
Yeah, so like, what are you doing here? Well, my son, he's just in a tournament. I don't want to be stuck waiting in a chair for 3 hours, so I'll play you at the X2 tables. What are you doing here? I think Infernoids is like the people in between. They're not little kids anymore, not men yet. So
you
they're like,
read the chat
ooh, I don't like. What's that?
You should read the chat quick.
Infernoids rock.
Infernoids rock.
No, yeah, they're actually fiends, not rock types, but thank you.
above it, especially for you, Dennis.
Hey, don't hate on my Infernoids.
Hey, look who it is!
He's
look
been
who
here,
it is.
Did you notice?
It's Jonathan!
It's Jonathan Sheehan.
Let's talk about
his
deck.
Name is there. So yeah, if you don't talk about your deck, it's cool, man. I don't want to talk about it
either. No, I'm trolling you. So, drumroll please. 40th place, Turbo Klee.
40th place, Turbo Klee. How did you not get top 32 of Turbo Klee? I'm just kidding.
Because X2 is the stupidest thing ever.
I'm just kidding, Bowie. Good job. Honestly, good job. I did not have any faith in Turbo Klee. I've never had any faith in any Klee because I play BA, you know. BA laughs at Klee. So
no, that's the funny story. Story time.
Okay.
So we were at Jack's right Thursday, right? Mm-hmm. So I was testing BA with Caesar. Mm-hmm. But I was doing so shit because my mills were so bad. Also, like, I don't trust my mills. But I'm playing Necross, right? I tried Necross, still did bad. So I brought Turbo Klee for fun that day, and then wrecked shit on everybody.
Damn, dude, wrecked shit, straight up.
So I was doing more research, and I was like, but I had understanding that Mexico and all those stuff, they top because they don't have access to Diamond Crab King. So my thought process is,
true.
I am going to bet that you don't have that card. I bet wrong.
That's true. I didn't know about that. How only America is Crab King, right?
Yeah.
So in other countries, it's only Star Eaters that are only out, or like DA or Honest. Moon Mirror Shield, yeah. But like, we essentially have a toolbox out to Tower. So yeah,
guys,
good for you.
This is why ARG banned Towers. I mean, the card's just literally broken. It doesn't let your opponent play.
So. You know, it's interesting, because before, you know, I used to think that if you could make a Towers, you could probably already win, because that means you have three Klees, and three Klees is usually, if not an OTK, it's halfway to the OTK. But, I don't know, for some reason or other, people are playing more Towers, and having, it's stumping people.
War changes. War never changes. But it changes a lot.
The question is, how did you guys find out, dude? I didn't tell anybody.
I didn't tell anyone either.
You told me. Like, I think Anthony told me. I don't know what Anthony found out. I think Anthony might have walked by you and he told me.
Yeah, you're.
I was joking.
Someone outed you.
I told him I was playing Ignites.
Oh yeah, so was Anthony. Who was it? It might have been Johnny. To be honest, it might have been Johnny. Johnny might have been
probably
walking around.
Because like I promise I did not tell anyone. Like I
no,
only
dude,
told
John, you
people who were in the game.
I think it was Johnny. Johnny, not John.
Okay. So yeah. I'll give a quick deck profile thing and I'll explain my matchups and shit.
For sure, man. I'll be a 10-minute break.
Okay. So I ran two towers, two monoliths, two scouts, triple carrier, double cephalopod, double disc, triple helix, double shell, triple stealth, triple chicken game, triple into the void, one DFPs, one sacrifice, one summer's art. That's just a 1-3 summer's art.
That's like you're crazy.
One terraforming, triple upstart, triple wavering eyes, and one skill drain. Side, somewhat techish, double MST, double Necro Valley, double pendulum impenetrable, one Raigeki, double light imprisoning, double lose a turn, one climate change, double shallow imprisoning, one vanities, and I don't give a shit about the side. Extra. I never went to it. So I felt bad, dude, because the first round I faded Senji, right? You know what the kid told me? Guys?
What did he tell you? He never played Yosenji before?
This is his first regionals.
A lot of people
Scumbag!
Say that. No, but no. This is his first regionals. He's not playing Klee Turbo, dude.
Well, he should be ready, man.
He wasn't ready. Oh, well, he got rid of towers because he like...
He wasn't ready. He like, wasn't ready.
No, because he messed up. He sighted in the loser turn still. I was like, well, okay. But then he pumped Tsujik twice, and that was fine. But I had plan B, which is towers too.
Sujik twice.
Yeah, he buffed himself up and did this card.
Are you not done yet? I left for like 10 minutes, man. Are you not done yet?
I felt so bad, dude. Because that was his first regionals and he had to play against this crap.
So, okay, probably never going to regionals again because of you.
Yeah, I'm sorry, kid.
Sorry,
kid. I didn't mean it.
The equivalent of Shawn Michaels super kicking Ric Flair.
Oh my god, that's just terrible.
How did you beat Rit Beast?
I'm gonna go over one by one, sorry. So next one I lost to Shadals because he fucking had the out. No, so I made first turn towers each time, but he happened to have the double juggler in hand. So he just made hat trigger to what's it called? Diamond Crab.
Okay.
So at game 2, I tried sizing the tech stuff, like the Shadow Imprisoning, lose the turn, did jack shit.
Okay, next one.
Ritual Beast.
Come on, hurry up, hurry this up, man.
No, dude, you have to know the details.
You have to know.
Ritual Beast, game 1, I wrecked. Game 2, I'm an idiot and forgot to sign MSTs, and I lost a mistake. Game 3, Towers of God. Fucking, okay, so game 4, Necroz, right? So I made Towers. He went first, he made Valk. I had towers, I ran to Valk, damage step. He didn't search it, man, he drew, he had his like opening hand.
The decisive armor.
And then like game 2 I tried siding again. It didn't work. At this point I was like, fuck it, I'm never going through this side deck ever again.
Or just lazy.
No, dude, it's okay, so round 3 is Harpies. The second I was like, I shouldn't be worried, this is terrible, I'm fine. Because if it's the stun version, I'm almost there, man. I'm out. Because like the stun version, I would be scared because he could pop my skill drains and right stuff, right? Not with Turbo Klee.
Yeah. Turbo Klee too strong.
Next round was a bye, and then I had to play against Fernoids. Holy shit, man! Nunku, 3 times.
That's scary.
No, it's Decatron and Nunku like once, but it's fine. Because Necro Valley and Vandy saved my ass. Woo.
Why does it stop?
Then afterwards, it was Heroes.
Can't pay.
No. Heroes, I won game 1, game 2, fucking Dark Law raped me. Game 3, Skill Drain is the God.
Well, this is a very good card. It's not one for a good reason.
So round 9, I had flashbacks, because I was in the same situation. X2 on the bubble. But then, BAM! I got a buy!
New Steve here.
And then last round, Shadals, it was close. He made Diamond Crab all the time, but I had the second tower, so he didn't get the out.
God damn.
No, so it's scary! Because, like, game 2, right? So I set I set Bandies and Impenetrable, knowing he has the crab, right? He drops Dankle.
Rex.
Okay.
I was like, thank God I didn't switch to my bullshit side. Okay, well, that was the last matchup. I got 40th place, I got my invite, I'm retired from Yu-Gi-Oh!
Oh wow, cool story, Grandpa.
Grandpa, tell it again, I will, okay? So, 10 rounds.
That was cool. Dennis, how'd you do?
I came in 138th.
138. What was the record?
X3.
X3.
Yeah.
I thought it was X3-1.
X3-1, you're right.
Ooh. That one will get you.
The one draw, dude. That's so sad.
That one draw will get you.
Oh, dude, you got fucking penalized. The warning.
I got a warning too.
For what?
For slow play, when I was moving my cards, when I was trying to make Trish.
It was that time.
But I couldn't make Trish.
It was that time.
I played a Gemini Shadal deck in round 8 or something like that. He made triple construct with forgot what it was, another card and a dragon on board, something like that. And then he attacked and Mirror Forced him, and I was like, cool, he's done, right? Nope, makes another Emerald, bring them all back, and I was like, fuck. And that one went to time in game 1 still, and then I ended up making Trish. Well, I econ his Emerald, took to put back my constructs, and then I made Trish and enemy controller his construct. Oh no. Yeah, and attack for game. And that was it. And he was playing Clown with the Gemini.
Clown Shadal Gemini?
Yeah, and then
damn,
he got himself down to 3,000 using his own trick clown, so he didn't have to drop for me.
That's the thing with like clowns.
Yeah, so that's it.
But Wait, what was the one you said you played?
Gemini.
Oh, the guy that called you on time. Is that your first time?
Yeah.
Someone called judge on you?
Yeah, judge called time on me.
I'm so shocked that you haven't been called out for time more often.
No, time is in slow play.
No, it's slow play.
Yeah, I know, but like usually like you call the judge and say, hey, like, judge got slow play.
Oh, this was during turns.
Yeah.
Oh, already in turns?
The judge is sitting there already.
Yeah.
No, my opponent didn't call it. The judge is standing there. He's like, I'm gonna give you a warning. Yeah, I'm like, what? I'm moving my cards. I play Batman and I'm trying to dump a damage juggler. He's like, that's a warning. I'm like, what? I'm moving my cards.
Whenever there's a judge sitting by, because I've gone to time like 2 times, and then there's always a judge sitting there, and it always stresses me out. But part of me also gets really angry because I'm like, you motherfucking loser. I know you couldn't make a single play if you were in my situation, because you didn't even know how to play, you know? Because most judges, they don't compete, you know?
Except it's for really Braveson. Stressful. Oh, that guy's cool.
He doesn't play, though.
Yeah, no, he doesn't play.
He's a cool guy, but I've never seen him play.
Wait, you think he's in here? He's not in here? He's not a cool guy?
Oh, David,
36 bags?
David, how'd you do?
Your seriousness makes me look at your judgment.
Don't go off too much.
I don't care. I don't care me. What's he gonna do, punch me in the stomach when I'm not looking?
David,
anyway, John, how'd you do?
I lost, but I was playing the Merry Christmas deck, and I beat Steve, so that was worth $12.
Yeah, a lot of Femi Fire.
Didn't you guys beat Steve?
No.
Or did you beat Steve?
I played Steve, and I beat him. Little David Belsa beat him.
Hey, Steve's having a bad day. Steve, what was it?
We gotta tell a story that happened to our friend Steve.
The waifus.
The waifus.
So, like, he was all prepared, like, oh man, I'm playing regional, I'm on the top, right? Dude, fuck it. So the day of, we were like, what the fuck is Steve? Turns out, he overslept till like 10 or 11.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
This is a kicker though. He had another person I know, he had decor. Steve has the decor.
Oh yeah, that's right.
So my friend had to go buy like singles from like random everybody just to get his deck ready.
Yeah.
Whoa, who's that?
That's Oscar.
Oh, ha ha ha.
So he sold the deck to a guy, and then Steve didn't show up, and he had to go find the deck.
I'm sorry, man, but Steve, you're a scumbag.
Hey, next, Steve. Hey, I got my Mystic boxes.
Yeah, so, but you're playing side, dude. Why are you playing main?
It was a plus for me, you know.
All right, moving on.
Dude, I had such a good time at regionals because I didn't play in the main event. I was trading. Oh my gosh, guys, I got my second. First edition Magic Ruler MST. For those that don't know, that's the original MST. Those things are like gold. Those things can only shoot up. It's like Apple stock.
It's like Apple stock.
So much story, dude. Like, what's it called? Like Johnny getting the Quasar.
Oh yeah, Johnny.
You got too many stories. You guys should have been there.
You know the Johnny story?
No.
So Johnny, he was trading for some cards, right? And then Johnny was short a dollar. And then Johnny was like, oh, just throw in that Quasar. It's only $1 from the Legendary Collection. Uh-huh. And then it's like, okay, cool. So he puts the Quasar in his binder, right? Uh-huh. And it goes to the next person to trade. And then the guy goes, oh, how much for this? The jump Quasar. And then he's like, what? Jump Quasar? It's like, oh, that's $15. Oh, plus. Yeah. No, another guy came up saying, oh, how much for the jump Quasar?
Yeah.
So the guy that traded him the Quasar for $1.
I know, but why didn't he say, oh, give it back? That's not fair.
No, he didn't know.
That's what I'm saying. He walked away.
He's way gone.
Yeah, he walked away.
Yeah.
Damn.
So the plus $15 is real quick. They even know.
Well, why is the Jump Quasar some, is a different rarity?
No, Jump Quasar is
Jump. I know, but they're both ultra, right?
No, it doesn't matter. Like, what's easier to get? Yes.
I don't know.
Yeah, so that's all stories.
Yeah, it was a good trading. I always trade at regionals. It's always a good time trading.
Yeah. Moving on.
Shout out to all the people we met.
Oh yeah, shout out to everybody that we met. Everyone I played. To the guy beat me. Fuck you, go.
Real talk, dude. You see what happens when I put Kappa?
That's Kappa?
Yeah.
Serious?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I'm sorry, but yeah, shout out to Yugimation. He was there.
That's the face.
All the people Dennis saw, they didn't acknowledge me. Dude, you don't have any pictures? Oh, can you give me a picture with Yugimation?
Oh no, you can't give me a picture of Yugimation because he
didn't want to. No, gotta take a picture. No, like, you know. So they asked me to take the pictures for them. They didn't even know who I was.
They asked the Bui to take pictures for Yugimation.
Oh, Bui, the girlfriend?
You're the camera guy.
You're the girlfriend. Taya.
Taya. All right, yeah, moving on. I try to move on to six subjects like 20 times already.
I'm sorry, that's the last thing.
I want a mat. Next topic.
Okay, if you want a mat, let's go to the next topic. Sponsors, quick, while I cry in the corner.
Morden Salt.
Morden Salt.
Always there for Bui.
You can season a chicken or a bad duelist.
So this weekend, this Saturday specifically, is the North American Yu-Gi-Oh! OTS Championship. Why is it not on the screen?
Is it only on Saturday? It's not Saturday, Sunday?
Yeah, just Saturday.
Only Saturday. I see. So what is OTS Championship?
Sorry, give me a second. It went blank on me for some reason.
Sure. John,
Okay, I'm just gonna bleed here. Just like, long story short, it's another way to get invites. It's pretty much a mini regionals. $20, you get either 4 Astros, 5 boosters, or 10 bat, but usual. But the key thing is, first place only gets the mat. Either by playing like top 8, whoever, or Swiss, last round of Swiss.
I like that.
And top 4 will get invites. And also, UDS points will be rewarded for next season, whatever.
How many people enter? 16? 128.
No. Like 128 more. So
however big your store is, can hold.
Now, so, here's the kicker. I was looking at locations, right?
Points to go, right?
No.
Oh, anybody can go?
Not UDS.
So, unfortunately, California only has one location. Core TCG.
It's a terrible location, too. It smells like fumes. I should talk to the health inspectors.
Smell like man, paint. What's your deal with Core TCG, man?
No, for real, though, it smells like paint. I don't know, man.
I don't know.
I think it's pretty weird how they only have one, because, I hope Konami knows that NorCal and SoCal are two different states. They should have one in NorCal, too.
Like, the main location's like SoCal, dude, like the main location for Yu-Gi-Oh stuff.
No, there's a lot of great duelists from San Jose and San Francisco. Let's not leave them out.
Denny. But I'm the headquarters.
Oh, well then, I see.
You should know.
Because Konami USA is based in SoCal.
I guess. I don't know. But you said you get points for UDS. Is that the ultimate duelist thing?
Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Get a belt.
The belt. Oh, the belt, you get it back. You know you give it back, right?
Yeah. Well, you get your name permanently
Oh, is it permanent?
Engraved, yeah.
So this is pretty interesting how the OTS is top 4 gets invite. Before, I believe it's only the first place gets invite and first place gets a mat. So I think it's pretty cool they put it in the top 4 now because I guess it gets pretty hard to get an invite if you're not from California.
I'm fine. I already have my invite. You guys on the
other hand. All right, Bui. Stop showing off now.
With my one booster pack?
Oh, yeah, you got one booster pack for top 8?
You pulled nothing from?
You got a mat, right?
No.
No.
Top 8.
Invite. You only get invite. Yeah. Only top 8 gets mat.
Oh.
Yeah.
How many get a pack? Top
64. Everyone gets invite.
It's just like different ratio.
Yeah.
I got the cutoff, dude. I was on the cutoff.
Yeah. I think you don't get packs for top 8. You didn't get packs, right?
No.
Yeah, he's got the mat. And then top 4 gets the booster box. The booster. Not booster. The deck box. Yeah.
Deck box. Okay, you're right.
Yeah. Before, I used to give out top 4 gets the binder. The
yeah, world. Yeah.
This is pretty cool.
I have
it in my room, actually. Very nice, actually.
No, not for traditionals. Yeah.
You would think.
I think back then with Konami days, they gave out pretty good prizes.
For 1,000 people entering, they should give you at least like a 3DS, right? Come
maybe,
on.
Maybe, yeah. I think before, when Upper Deck held it, regionals used to get like real big prizes. Yeah. So, but that's up to the
TL.
Yeah, not for TFL, the event coordinator. Yeah. So that's what the West Coast Gaming will do whatever they want. Because then we know at Vegas they're giving out free stuff for like free boxes at, like every round.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's, but that's up to the organizer. Yeah. So yeah, it's pretty cool.
So last sponsor before I change the last subject.
Man, I'm running out, man.
iPhone. I'm gonna get the new iPhone. I pre-ordered it. I'm gonna get the new 6S.
How much was it?
It was like $810.
$810? Where'd 10 come from? Tax?
Yeah. Well, it was $750 plus tax.
Oh, okay. $750 plus tax. Yeah. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So, Apple?
I don't like Apple.
Just iPhone.
Yeah.
You dropped your, you sell your laptop, your MacBook?
I do sell the MacBook. That might be still pretty good. I dropped it like 3-4 times. Usually you drop a laptop, kaputs, but that solid aluminum unibody holds up.
Yep.
So, last topic of the day. Special announcement. YCS Doubts in San Jose.
Oh yeah, not a lot of people know this, but YCS San Jose is happening November 6, 7, 8. It's a month right after Dallas. And we're going to be at both. I don't know about you, but I'm going
to
be
probably go to San Jose.
Yeah. So YCS Dallas, I'm going to be there. David's not going to be there. He has a hot date that day. I'm sorry. And Bowie has a hot date, too. I don't know.
My work status is in limbo.
Yeah. He has a hot date that day. I don't know if he's going to cancel on her. He's a douchebag. I don't know what he does on his own time.
I make her pay for the meal, dude.
Yeah, YCS Dallas will be there Friday, Saturday,
total
Sunday.
Total D-bag.
And YCS San Jose will probably be there Friday, Saturday, Sunday as well. And we're also selling shirts for $8. You can
pre-sale.
You can pre-sale it. You can order it on our Project YGO Facebook page. Just message us on there. And it's pretty much the same shirt you guys always see us wear, the black one. But it's going to be white on black instead of black on white. And then we also have another one that David designed, which is...
We'll
post it on the website, on Facebook. If you guys saw my last video, it's on there too. It's pretty cool. $8 is freaking dirt cheap. The fabric's really nice. Yeah. It's not like cardboard fabric.
Yeah, and if you order it before, you know, YCS San Jose and YCS Dallas, you can get it for $8 plus shipping and handling. However, depends on where you live, obviously. And then after that day, it'll probably be around 10 or $12 a shirt. So.
But if you're at San Jose or Dallas, no shipping, because I'll be there at the church. Just tell me that you're gonna be there. We're gonna shirts to you guys.
And hand delivered.
I can sign it too if you want, but I don't know. Probably don't want me to sign it.
Yeah.
You can ask David to sign it. I'll put a digital stamp on it or something. Yeah. So we'll be at Dallas. A lot of us will be at Dallas. So what about October 3rd? It says San Jose for the regionals. All right. October 3rd is gonna be YCS Dallas. November 6th is gonna be YCS San Jose. So
San Jose has regionals around the same time as YCS Dallas.
Yeah, so
but then fast forward a month. So San Jose is gonna have a regionals in October and then a YCS in November.
Yeah. So
double the chances.
Say again?
No, I'm saying double the chances.
Double the chances, yeah. So we'll be back to back.
If you top YCS you get invite?
Yeah.
If you top YCS you get invite, yeah. Okay. That's people say that's a real invite, not a regional invite. Topping YCS is how you get into nationals.
Dude, I top LA, I don't care no more.
Yeah, topping LA is kind of like pretty big too, because it's 1,000 people. Some YCS aren't even that big.
Yeah.
I'll do YCX Mexico 300 something, but that's different
stuff. Ooh, that's not worse, man. Ooh, you got top 64, next time you go for top 32, then you get top 16, then you go top 8. That's what you gotta think about it, man.
No, watch, I got top 8, sir. You've been stacking, you're being a band.
Damn, dude.
Boo's banned.
Stacking, you're banned.
Boo's always been.
You're gonna get banned.
He's been a sack, but not this much of a sack.
Yeah.
Something's wrong.
Yeah. So that's pretty much it, right, Bowie?
Yeah.
Yeah. So
they haven't updated yet. They just announced it. So.
Yeah, they have updated on the website. They have not updated on the website. It's we got confirmation at LA Regionals.
The actual event.
Yeah.
Tio told us.
No.
Yeah.
Shout out to JCS.
Yeah. Shout out to JCS.
Juan Carlos.
So, yeah, if you guys watched my last video, I had the picture on it. It had the slip with the paper on it. So you guys booked your hotels and booked your flights. So, yep. And that's pretty much it, Bowie?
Yeah, so goodbye, guys. Johnny. Adios. Ciao, Quibi.
Johnny is stupid.
catch you guys on Twitch.
Catch us on Twitch.
This is a dumb format.
I don't like this format either.
All right, there, guys. Have a good dinner, have a good night, and we'll see you guys in the next podcast Monday, which is going to be on Twitch, because fuck YouTube.